No, you're not going in.
Let the record show that you just battered me.
Step back.
And you're using... Oh!
Welcome to the John Ligato Show. I'm John Ligato. My cousin, Vinny the Viking, has a request on my behalf.
Thank you for watching the video. If you don't hit subscribe, I will come and pillage your village. Press the button. Press it now. Press it!
Howdy, sir.
Hey.
Deputy Kruger with Cass County Sheriff's Office.
Deputy Kruger?
Yep.
Nice to meet you.
Is there something I can help you with today, or...
No, I don't need any help with anything.
Okay. I was just wondering, because we saw you on our cameras, you were over there, wandering around over by the van over there and stuff. And just
yeah, I was just taking some pictures and video over there, yeah.
Okay. All right, are you here to pick somebody up from the jail, or what's up?
No, I'm not here to pick anyone up from the jail.
Okay. All right, well, if you don't have any business here, I would ask if you could move along. You can hang around at the front of the building. You can hang around at the front of the building if you want, but as you can see, we've got these signs around talking about no loitering outside of the jail and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I read the statute. It has to do with communication with inmates and passing documents towards inmates, and I'm not doing that.
We have a sign prohibiting individuals from just standing near a fence in close proximity to a county jail. This involves two issues, one legal, one logical. The legal issue. Can the county enforce the sign? But first, we're going to allow Reyes to explain the logical issue of...
I read the statute. It has to do with communication with inmates and passing documents towards inmates, and I'm not doing that.
Sean claims he's not doing that, and maybe we should believe him. But why would any officer believe some sleazy-looking guy loitering next to a prison for an hour and then claiming...
I'm not doing that. I'm engaged in a constitutionally protected activity.
Okay. Well, I would ask that if you, you can hang out front and stuff. Anywhere we've got these signs posted, we would ask that you not loiter around that area. Okay.
Yeah, I'm not loitering. I'm not standing. Loitering is standing around without a purpose.
It is unlawful for any person to loiter or prowl in a place at a time or in a manner not usual for law-abiding individuals.
Logically and visually, Reyes is at a place, a jail. And behaving in a manner, which he's just standing there with a camera, that is not usual for law-abiding individuals. My father, the cop, would have summed this up with, that person's up to no good.
Did I check in?
Did I check in?
Yeah.
No.
The visitors come here, they check in. You should check in.
Typically?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Meeting everybody, so you should check in.
No, I'm not going to check in.
Oh,
no.
That's weird.
What does checking in entail, Steve?
Checking on public safety to let them know why you're here and what you're doing.
No, but what does that entail?
You should ask Joey. I'll tell you.
I mean, you're the one talking. Joe's not talking to me about it. You are. So
it's
I'm asking you.
Irrelevant. You should check in with Joey, please.
No, Joe hasn't talked to me about it, so...
Please hold on right here, please. Thank you.
Yeah.
Joey, could you check in, please?
What's up, Joe? You need my driver's license?
Yeah.
Really? To enter in a town hall?
Yeah.
Wow. Do you do that with everybody?
Yeah.
Every single person that comes into town hall, you tell them, you make them give you your driver's license. Did you know that's a violation of the Fourth Amendment?
I mean, IDs are required to board a plane, rent a hotel room, go into a liquor store, a dance club, a bar, a casino, even if you don't play. Banks, corporate offices, to rent shoes at a bowling alley, prescriptions, nail polish, and to vote in 35 states. You will need an ID.
Yeah, I'm trying to speak to the town attorney. This is very concerning that you're forcing free American citizens to relinquish their driver's license, which is a violation of the Fourth Amendment. I understand. Well, you're not going to get my license. I'm not going to allow you to violate my rights to enter in a public building, but... That's something I will take up with the town attorney, for sure.
Thanks, Joe.
Respectfully. I'm speaking respectfully to you, too,
mm-hmm.
as well.
Okay.
Right?
I mean, I'm just trying to I'm trying to help both sides.
Yeah.
And you're saying that you're recording, you're trying to get everything at a certain point. Like, how long are you going to stay here?
Yeah, but the
they are seeing that they're only.
I'm on the side following the law. They're on the side just of their own personal opinion. I'm following the law. I'm exercising a First Amendment right.
I understand that. We're just trying to say, can you be considerate?
Like, yeah. Well,
if you could just be considerate.
They weren't very considerate.
Officer,
do you think that calling the police on somebody is a considerate? They weren't being considerate of me. That's not a private room, sir.
According to them, it is. They work here. It's a private room.
That door was wide open, sir. What's your name, sir?
I'm Stephen Pollock.
Stephen who?
Stephen Pollock. What's your name?
Stephen Pollock?
Yes.
Yeah, I didn't give it. Give it. Great.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well. You got to be a little bit more friendly.
Yeah.
A little bit more friendly you'd be great.
And auditor court jesters. Stephen Pollock is acting fine here.
Yeah.
A little bit more friendly you'd be great. What position do you hold here at the town hall?
I am the director of governmental research.
Wow, what do you do? What does that entail? Director of governmental research.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what does that entail? Obviously, following journalists around, is that part of your job description? Yeah, I'm an independent journalist, gathering content for a story. So.
The judge implied that I was just going around harassing people and calling it journalism.
Well, you have no expectation of privacy in public, ma'am.
I do.
What this place entails, it's a public place.
Yeah.
I'm a human being that has a right to be recorded or not recorded.
So no, you should choose a different profession, ma'am, honestly. I'm not trying to be an a-hole with you. I'm just trying to say that you're a public employee.
Are you almost done, or what?
Well, yeah, I'll be done in a few minutes.
Maybe just wrap it up, because everybody in here feels uncomfortable.
Yeah, I mean,
I know you have the right, and what you're saying, but for them...
Yeah.
They feel uncomfortable. They got work to do.
Mm-hmm. I'm just going to fade into the background. They can get back to their work.
It's uncomfortable for anybody that they're being videoed.
I know, but
they're just trying to work.
I didn't go up to people and start recording them, officer. And can I get your name and badge number, please?
It's Andrew Miro, right there.
I can't see that phone.
You said you're a journalist?
Yeah, correct.
Do you have any journalist credentials?
None that I'm going to provide.
So let's think about it this way. Let's think about the norm.
Yeah.
Right? So the security cameras that are all over this building, mm-hmm. they're there every day, right?
Correct.
So they become normal in everyday life. Kind of like the mask that you're wearing.
I'm glad you're saying that.
Right? A guy walking around filming, while you're allowed to, and you don't have any right to do so, and we've told you that, it's not normal. Therefore, people call the police because they see something out of the norm.
Wow, what a great take the officer made. And Reyes does assert that he doesn't approach anyone to bother them, but that camera and his silence is the beginning step to establish reasonable suspicion that something could be wrong. And remember, reasonable suspicion does not rise to probable cause, which is facts and circumstances. Reasonable suspicion is a gut reaction based on your experience.
Let's think about the norm.
Yeah.
Right? So the security cameras that are all over this building, mm-hmm. they're there every day, right?
Correct.
So they become normal in everyday life. Kind of like the mask that you're wearing.
I'm glad you're saying that.
Right? A guy walking around filming, while you're allowed to, and you don't have any right to do so, and we've told you that, it's not normal. Therefore, people call the police because they see something out of the norm.
Okay. So
which is why we come and talk to you.
Which is, and I can see that point, and which is exactly why I go around in city buildings and I film. I want it to become normal.
So a question. When auditors shove a camera in the face of public employees, private business owners, or citizens, do they conclude, this is normal?
The John Ligato Show is being broadcast from outside the gates of Marine Corps Base Camp Lejeune in beautiful North Carolina. If you like the show, subscribe. Doesn't cost you anything, and we don't ask for personal information. Semper Fidelis.